yesterday, I think around 3:15, 3:30 in the afternoon, I believe I finished all the priest assignments for next year. Now, there's an old saying, if you want to make God laugh, just make plans. It's one of the more challenging responsibilities I have as the ordinary, to try and get the right priest in the right place for the right people. One year, I think I did a particularly bad job of that, and I was complaining to Brother Bishop how could I've done that, the 2020 bishop, in a couple of weeks after the assignment begins. And the bishop looked at me, shook his head, and he said, you know, Dan, if you get every priest in the right place, that's called heaven. You live in Peoria. I have a close priest friend in the congregation of Holy Cross. We're about the same age. He's had a lot of really serious responsibilities. He had big jobs at Notre Dame. He became president of the University of Portland. He turned that school around in many ways, made it the Catholic University of the Northwest. He raised a ton of money, increased enrollment, did all things well. In fact, so well that they elected a provincial superior, which for an international congregation is the provincial who really is in charge. And we were absorbing two other weak provinces into one province of priests in the United States. And in any job like that, there's tons of pushback, people upset, angry. And when he finally retired from that job, he started teaching full time back at Notre Dame. And then, just this month, they asked him to be the interim president of another Holy Cross institution. And as he told me, I had to take this for the team. It wasn't something he was dying to do. We talk a lot, and sometimes on the phone, sometimes over dinner. We have this fantasy. We're both the same age. And either I say to him, or he says to me, wouldn't it be wonderful to be back in grammar school? When Pius XII was pope, Eisenhower was president, and mom and dad were in charge. I was exhilarated. Was a really great man, a holy man, a pastoral man, a tough man. And he would send me out to do things. Sometimes you see him and you tell him, and it wasn't that hard. Everybody knew I was representing the boss. So I knew what I was told. But you know, I was just the messenger. Everybody knew his authority was behind me, and his will was giving the words to my lips. Today's gospel, actually a lot of the gospels this week, have to do with what authority Jesus had to say what he said and do what he did. Today's gospel, he reminds his listeners and us today, he represents the Father. If you want to know what God is like, read the gospels and see what Jesus is like. He is the full revelation of who God is and what God is all about. Every word of the Bible is true, but those words are not understandable fully until we encounter Jesus Christ. His Father gave testimony that Jesus was sent into this world by the will of the Father. There is, of course, no end to the love between the Father and the Son. That love is so great, it is the Holy Spirit. And so Jesus was like us in all things but sin, never ceased to be God's only begotten Son. And we can have confidence in what he teaches us. But there's kind of a scary part of this. Jesus chooses us to be his representatives in this world. Jesus asks us to be his witnesses. Jesus asks us, and in front of a group like this that does so much to build up the body of Christ in this world, to be his hands, to be his heart, to be his words of prayer, to make him present to everyone we meet, not so relentless. It's not easy to be a Catholic Christian, and guess what? It was never intended to be easy. We share the cross of Christ, but we remember in history, victory is ours. He has already won the prize. He passed through death so we could live forever. He shared his truth with us. He poured out his Holy Spirit, and he even gives us his body and his blood. So we are fed by that bread that has come down from heaven, that antidote to death itself, that possibility of being in intimate communion with the risen Christ, even on this earth, even before he comes again in glory and makes perfect this wounded world. If you're like me, sometimes get a little scared. Sometimes say, well, how could I have done that? Sometimes I'm not sure what the right choice is. We have to remember who Jesus is, our priest, our mediator, our savior, our Lord, and our God. His truth was proven on Easter Sunday morning, and one day we will share fully in that victory. So we don't have to go back to the 1950s to feel safe. Right now, in the 20th century, we know that there is nothing but the skies or the earth that can finally hurt us.